Welcome to Oracle Marketing Cloud Help Center videos. In this video, we will cover how to make a multi-step campaign in Eloqua. We'll start by introducing what a multi-step campaign is, how it can be useful, and then demonstrate how to create one. Multi-step campaigns are marketing campaigns that are created on the campaign canvas. They are highly customizable to meet your marketing campaign needs. Using the canvas, you can include different elements such as emails, landing pages, decisions, and actions. You can assemble and configure all of these elements directly on the campaign canvas, saving you time and helping you create a campaign workflow that meets your needs. Unlike a simple campaign, a multi-step campaign can be a lot more complex and personalized. Now let's create a multi-step campaign together. On your My Eloqua dashboard, navigate to Orchestration and then click Campaigns. Now in the Campaigns overview, click the Create a Multi-Step Campaign tile. You can decide if you want to use a template or not. I will be using the default blank template, which is a clean canvas. Now that you have a canvas, you can drag and drop different elements from the left side palette onto the canvas to create your campaign. First, let's name our campaign. You can name your campaign based on the email, the intended recipients, or whatever naming conventions you follow. I will be naming mine EMEA Q116 Breakfast Roadshow. Since the campaign must have a segment telling us what contacts will be targeted in this campaign and an email to send to that segment, let's go ahead and drop those elements onto the canvas. If you prefer, you can also double-click an element and it will appear on the canvas, and then configure them accordingly. I will be targeting contacts in the EMEA area and will be sending them an invite to my next roadshow. After you have placed these elements on the canvas and configured them, you must connect them. Click the gray dot on the segment and drag it to the email. This creates a connection between the two elements. Now, since my email included a form where contacts can sign up for the roadshow, I'm going to add a decision step to track what happens with the form. A decision step lets you decide what you sent to contacts, depending on whether or not they submitted the form. To do this, first drag the submitted form decision from the left palette onto the canvas. After you place the step where you like, you must configure it properly. First, make sure the correct form is being tracked, and then decide how long you're allowing for your contacts to submit the form. I will be allowing a week before I'll send a follow-up email. After you've configured the step, create a connection between the submitted form decision and the email. Now you can decide what will happen to the contacts depending on whether or not they submit the form within the time frame. In my case, if someone doesn't sign up, I'm going to send a gentle reminder email. If they do sign up, I'll send them a confirmation email. That way, I can confirm their attendance and maybe include a calendar invite. It's a good idea to send the contacts that are attending the roadshow a reminder the day before, so that they don't forget to attend. This can be especially useful if there is a long time period between the email confirmation and the roadshow date. To do this, add a wait step onto the canvas and connect it to the confirmation email. Then, you can configure the wait step to send a reminder email the day before the roadshow. After you configure the wait step, add the last reminder email to the canvas reminding attendees to come to the roadshow. Now that you've finished creating the campaign, let's configure the settings so that we can activate it. To do this, open the right side palette, either by clicking the right side icon or by clicking Campaign Settings in the Options menu. Here you can give your campaign a description, which is optional but recommended. That way, you have a clear idea of the campaign's purpose when you or others revisit it later. For instance, mine is about inviting EMEA contacts to a roadshow. Then you must configure the activation settings. In this dashboard, you can decide the start and end dates for your campaign. You can also decide if you'd like to allow contacts to re-enter into the campaign and if you'd like to sync to your CRM. Once you've applied the appropriate settings to your campaign, you can verify it to make sure that everything is working properly. If your campaign has any validation errors, they will appear in a window on the canvas. If not, a notification at the bottom of the canvas will notify you that you do not have any validation errors. After verifying your campaign, you can click the Activate button and your campaign will be activated. Now you've finished your multi-step campaign. Once your campaign has been activated, you can access reports to see how it is performing. Simply navigate to the Campaign Settings dashboard and click the Reports tab. Here you can see Insight and Operational Reports. This concludes this tutorial on creating a multi-step campaign. Thank you for watching.